Aloha DC fandom. I apologize for the 4-year wait.
Oh my gosh, I've been there since 2017.
But I'm very proud of the sequel because it's tackling a lot of issues environmentally. Stakes are higher and I'm just excited because I had a big part in my boy James, you know?
Super sweet, man.
Check it out, I'm excited for you to see it. Tides are changing. This is important, the tides are changing.
Like the comic book, the world of Aquaman is so big and so rich.
It's epic, it's huge, it's colorful. The world is at stake.
I'm super excited to be back making the sequel. I have so much invested into it. I love this character. I love what it represents. There's nothing that I've ever been a part of that's like this.
People are going to be in for a treat. When Aquaman 2 comes out, they're going to get a movie that's more mature, but yet still retain its fun to give the audience something different, something new that they haven't seen before.
The success of that movie as the biggest DC movie of all time shows what James Wan and his team were able to do. And in this second film, we have turned the dials up to 11. It has the action, the fun, the heart.
Action!
Superheroes and supervillains have entertained generations of fans across the globe.
Good, you got it? We'll put that in the movie?
To play around with this cast again is quite a trip. We're having a blast. This movie's a lot of fun.
I think fans are going to be very happy. And I think James is really excited to go all out.
This is an exciting scene. We better get to a little bit of action.
It's going to be a fun adventure, like it was the first time. Just better.
We see that Black Manta is still seeking his vengeance to try and kill Aquaman. That's gonna be something that's exciting for the audience, something for them to be swept up into the world of Aquaman again.
About to kick some ass.
It's a globe-trotting story. We visit so many different worlds. This movie isn't afraid to embrace its fantasy and go on this magical journey. I think it's gonna be really awesome.